now we get underway. The Battle of Broom Street, the grand final rematch. Cottesloe kick deep into the Associates 22. We get underway now. It's a good first carry there by Davies. Firing across the back here. Associates looking for an option, but can't find much space on the first carries there. Still going to run the ball. Don't want to kick it away too early into the Breeze. Breeze going to the diagonal back left corner of your screens there. Few personnel changes for both sides and a couple force inclusions as well. And that one was taken back inside the 22. So the first mistake of the day is going to come off the Associates' boot. Believe it was off the boot of maybe Ingram. And Cottesloe are going to get the first line out of the afternoon inside the 22. Full line. Up at two was Elliott. And just brought to ground. Now they're trying to find pod runners. Rolling forward. Nichols in at half. Flat ball. Soaks trying to rush up onto the defense, but getting bumped off. Slow ball. Now firing. Good carry. Noble stepping inside the first. Nickel darts. Brought to ground by Phillips. And then lost, stripped in the tackle. Lost forward advantage here. Ingram cracks inside the first. Clearing kick coming. Lalaga in the pocket. Ready to receive. Slow ball. Kicks now. Good shaping kick. Not out though. Held up in the wind. Meredith. Bit of confusion with his opposite man. Absolutely crunched in the tackle. Surprised no one blew a knee in that one. Up on the 22 once again. Referee today, Sunderland, was having a look at it. Decided to let it play. No one at home from the box kick, Phillips. Shrugging off the first. Good little run there by Kamara. Across the back, Theo Strang, Force Academy. Out on the left here. No penalty coming the way of Associates. I was going to say on the left here is going to be the first touch for Brakey. The Western Force winger. Not to come though. What a quick little passage of play we open up with there,
yeah,
Seb.
Yeah, wow, this is a great way to start. Obviously, grand final rematch, Battle of Broom Street. So it's exactly how we wanted to start.
Penalty 48 out from the line. Probably too far for the boot off Lalaga. Or even Ingram. And not the best kick into touch, but it's metres gained nonetheless. 40 metres will be the trip into the line. The referee, Ian Sunderland, hasn't quite seen the blood stoppage and will have time off now.
He's caught one in the schnoz there.
Yeah, just a little bit of blood coming out of the nose. Doesn't look too serious, just waiting for the medic team just to chuck something up in that nose of his. And for the first time in a few years, looks like Associates have the bigger side. Normally quite a small ball-running side. Cottesloe trimmed down, dropped a bit in height, a few of their players. And almost the biggest man out there for them is their captain, number 8, Tobias Hoskins, an absolute Stableford. Very successful captain for Cottesloe, 2 premierships now. Sounding to throw, Soaks. Up at 6, bring it down, not straight.
Option. Outside arm. Option.
Scrum's going to be the option taken move. Here by Cottesloe. Scrum. Let's see who gets up on this big affair. Good midfield scrum. Both teams are going to have a crack at this type of opportunity. Interesting to see how these two packs weigh out against each other today. Number 3 for Cottesloe. The loose head. Gerard Fadiotoa. Very technical scrummer on the far side for Cottesloe. surprised if he's got the ability to just turn this one up on the outside. Give his halfback Nickel a little bit of space just to clear this one easily. Have a reset, just reset that gap. Cotter's low set quite flat across the back line. Two at the back, four flat across the front. Might be a jab and kick test Ingram early. No, early. Tap and go the call. Good little ball carry there. Masson.
Advantage not rolling.
Advantage not rolling. Everything going the way of Cotterslow in the last couple minutes so far.
Get his number for me, please. Justin.
Short side. Cutout pass is a good one. Now they can find a bit of hands, but it goes through them all. We'll come back penalty.
Not rolling.
Certainly a little bit of pace early on in this one as the kick to corner comes. And Seb, a little bit about these conditions today. How good are they?
Yeah, it's fantastic. Obviously, Cotterslow notorious for being a little bit too windy, but just a slight breeze out there shouldn't mess with the players too much.
Coastal breeze just coming over our shoulders with the cameras as you see them. It's not too much as you see normally as this one gets tipped over at the back. Associates have won against the feed and they're inside their own 22. Chance to exit. Lalaga goes back to pocket but they shift left instead. Ingram dancing. No. High tackle is the call from the sideline. We're going to come back. And what do you think they should be doing here, Seb?
Yeah, well, it's an interesting play out. I think they should maybe take the points.
Take the points is the correct call every single time early in a first grade game like this.
Yep.
Shot called.
Yep. I'll take my advice.
So off the first red zone penalty of the day, high tackle.
As we said, not a whole lot of breeze out there.
It's kind of directly behind him here as well.
Yep.
So as long as he keeps it on this left hand, you know, just in on the left hand side a bit.
Just on the inside, yep.
Shouldn't be too much trouble for him. Benjamin Meredith, the kicker.
And he's taking your advice there. Good conversion.
So the penalty can successful. 3 points to nil. Cotterslow are up in the Battle of Broome Street. And look at them all up in the hill on the background.
It is packed out in the last 10 minutes.
They've gained some new sponsorships down here, Cotterslow, and I'm sure the fans, they're happy about it. They're making use of all the resources up on the hill this afternoon.
Absolutely. And obviously, first day back after some ease restrictions here in Perth, so it's good to see.
Everyone happy to be out and about without their masks on. This one lands just on the 22. Nowhere to really go, so just accepts the contact. Cotterslow fanning across. I believe Holloway carrying. Pocket now. And that's a great kick downfield. Plenty of length. He's going to turn Ingram almost inside out. Has to fire across. Lalaga looks up. Little chip. Finds a bit of grass. Bracky fires across to Meredith. Now on the outside. Opportunity to have a crack down the left wing. Now firing back. Meredith again. Going all the way to the corner. Cotterslow in again. It's Theo Strang. The number 10 for Cotterslow, just running a beautiful support line down the wing. And they've managed to score a second try. Sorry, their first try of the afternoon. Second points of the afternoon. And all the pressure immediately on the Osiasokes back line. Just to shut things down when the ball's getting run directly towards them. I really liked as well the experience. Marcel Brachy there just giving that offload. He got the ball on the run back and just dished it off to the fullback. Just a smart bit of play, has all the time in the world. Kick to come in from the corner. 8-0 currently.
Soaks were very quick there back to regroup and have a chat about what's going down and what changes they need to make early, because obviously Cotterslow putting some scoreboard pressure on early.
I think it's just about being fanned out as well. They've just been...
Yep.
Couple times just looked a little bit too tight, getting beaten around the edge. certainly not too many weak links in defense in that Soak side there. They can all tackle quite well. So no reason to be sucking in, forcing two-man tackles. As we wait for the kick from the corner. That's a good-looking one, too. Wow, does it have the distance?
Fantastic.
Gee, they might have lost Caleb Young, but Benjamin Meredith has stepped up with the boot and he's gone 2 for 2 early. It's 10 points to nil.
Caleb who, they're saying?
Caleb who needs him. Certainly UWA have fancied, fancied him over there.
Yep.
He's been an absolute highlight for them with the boot so far this season and they're currently undefeated. Cottesloe and Associates can't say the same as the grand final participants of last year even. Phillips fills into half. Dawson carries up. Trying to move this one quickly. Ingram. Phillips dummying but didn't have anywhere to dart through himself, so gets crashed back a meter or two. Support arrives underneath him. No half. Cottesloe. Tobias Hoskins has come straight through the middle.
Bang the ball on the ground.
And he thought he was okay for a second. Shakes his head in disbelief. Thought he got away with it for a second, but no, says the referee.
Playing the ball off the feet.
And at 10 points to nil. Associates take the points. Love to see it. Jeez, the nose is gone again there in centre field.
Yeah, it's two.
I believe it's
extra medical attention.
Is it Janet Lynch? I believe it is. That nose has busted open twice early in this game, so he's receiving tension again. The kicker as well here, Tuologo Lalaga. Been an absolute find for Associates this season as well. Fresh to Perth Rugby and has made an absolute impact straight away. As he makes contact now with the ball, shaping, looks left, is left. It's going to be a 22 dropout. That's not a drop kick. That is not a drop kick. Gee, this is Premier Grade Rugby, and I know he's not a kicker himself, the big flanker.
Just don't make mistakes like that usually.
It's a 22 dropout. It's in the name.
Oh.
You know? Can't be making mistakes like that. Carl Masson, he won that one again. Scrum down on the 22. We'll see what setup Associates go with here. So 3-2. Three out on the left. Laga the playmaker for Ingram. And then out on the right, Tom Ingram, the little brother of Ingram. Setting out with a little bit more open space. Cott's going to match up 3-3. Left they go. Laga attacking the line. Cut out ball immediately. Vanavere looking at the line sharply.
Tackle!
I believe that might even be Jacobson on left wing.
Tackle.
Both wearing the same headgear today. Got them wrong.
Will be tough to tell them apart.
Tap and goes the call. Associates quick play of the ball attacking the line. Sowney brought to ground 5 out. Phillips goes fishing, dishes it out now. Lynch. Penalty advantage coming, so Associates can try something in the corner here. Ingram can't get free. Need someone to release. Phillips, whoa, too high there. Surely, no, he's hurt his own eyeball as well.
He's
in a lot
himself.
Of trouble there, the man from Cottesloe. Very tough soldier, and you don't normally see him stopped like that. Ingram gets through. Short of the line, 1 metre out now. New advantage, that's 3 inside the 22. We're going to have to be having a chat soon. And we're just wisely let them all calm down with a bit of time off. Danger signs here for the man from Cottesloe.
No, still in some trouble now. He's gone down to one knee.
Penalty is over here. 15.
Might have just caught one straight in the eye.
One down here for Associates as well. That's Norman.
Having a look at the knee, I believe.
I'm happy with that, okay? It was right.
Oh, it's Jared Fatiatoa, a good academy player for a Cottesloe that is down. Coming into this side to make a big impact. On an 18, maybe it isn't him. Thought it was 3, had him on the ankle. Oh, on the angle, sorry.
He's back on his feet now. I think he's okay. Might have just took the wind out of him a bit there, the pain. He's back up and he looks like he'll join his teammates again. Some more attention being paid to that man you mentioned before.
Yeah, Tom Norman. Another great lock for Associates. Time back
on.
Says he's going to play away.
Lynch once again getting some more attention to the nose. Just cannot get that to stop bleeding at the moment.
I think he's going to have to go off. You get 15 minutes with your blood stoppage. Just have 15 minutes. Let that relax.
Yeah.
Clot up a little bit. Find a tampon. Put it up there. Problem solved.
Like he's got a bit of stuffing up there now. So he looks ready to go, Lynch.
And after all that, surely Soaks aren't going to tap and go. That's a risky kick for touch here, Lalaga.
Not happy with it, are you?
It's just a hard kick. You can make that wrong on so many occasions. See, he's gone backwards there on purpose to make sure he hasn't screwed that one up. He's gone backwards when he could have had a 3 free points. Take the points, kids. Nevertheless, line out. Probably 8 out from the line now. Ooh, late lift up at 6.
Oh,
not
ball.
Contested. Maul set up. Great little setup here. Associates a little bit fat. They could have been thinner through it, but they get the ball rolling now.
Advantage.
Penalty advantage against Tobias Hopkins, the captain, came through the side. So penalty advantage. Can have a crack. Lalaga, cross kick. It's shaping nicely.
Whoa.
This is a big one. No, just bounces into touch. We'll come back for the penalty.
Back here.
Gee, I thought that one was a good little chance for Caleb Jacobson there for a second. Out on the left wing.
Number 8, changing your bind.
Bryce Hoskins just getting caught changing binds. Will they go to the corner again? They will. Up at 6 again. Maul formed. A lot tighter this time by both sides.
That's one, Socky. Use it.
Trying to get the ball free. Can't find it. Lockie Phillips. Now they start fumbling forward, but this is going to be a collapse. Maul. Scrum cop.
Very happy about it there.
Yeah,
just
better.
Shifted in the end and collapsed on the Associates. Much better Maul, but not the same result.
Better by both sides as well. Cop really better on defense there, and Associates just got a little bit thinner and a little bit straighter, trying to get a power set up. But just couldn't get the shove rolling, and a good call by the referee, not going anywhere. And just spun itself down into the ground. Scrum cop ball. And I think now. Ready to chase it. Penalty straight down.
Goal 3 down.
Just couldn't hold the pressure on the near side here. Jaden Lynch. Probably wasn't good to go straight down on that nose as well. Even more trouble for himself. Kick, not the best one, finds its way down on the golf course.
Some blood streaming.
Yeah, he's gone straight down on that from the scrum.
Numbers blue.
Better be a big casualty early to the associate scrum. Hoskins wins it off the top. Nickel feeding. Now we go back to Meredith off the boot. Ingram underneath this one. Solid as a rock. Looks up. Just has a probing kick, but I don't really only think he looked up at the defense, saw that they were that set up behind the ball. They were all pretty well expecting it. And going quickly. Calls a touch from the crowd, but it was an incidental touch by someone not really part of the game at all. Happy to play away there. Center field now, Sowney. Driven back a little bit, good tackle. No fullback. Can get the kick if they can get it free. Trying to find something, Dawson. Good defensive setup here from Cottesloe, so they have to fire back on the left-hand side, finding a little bit of space, now going to the ground. Net gain of 20 metres off that. That was a great little short side attack. Hemi Davies attacks up at the line. That's got to be in the side. It's going to be a collapsed ruck. No, lost forward first. So about 15 minutes into the first half here. What are you seeing, Seb?
Yeah, it's obviously Cottesloe just on the board. And they showed more signs early on, but it feels like the associates have just sort of found their feet in the second half of this first half. And, they're definitely more attacking in their play. But yeah, obviously we've seen the talents of the Western Force Academies from Cottesloe take the field and do quite well, so we'll see them shine out, especially in the second half of this one.
As we get ready for another scrum.
Crouch!
Cottesloe got two on the blind side. I would not be surprised
Crouch!
If this one fires out to the left and we see a probing Fine. Kick into the back right corner into the fresh patch of limestone Jack. Down here at Cottesloe. Strength set up for it and two chases. No, they pick blind anyway. They're going to just fire them off. See what they can do. They gain their way almost up to the opposition 10. Counter ruck's good here from associates, and they get the penalty straight back.
Big response here from the associates after Cottesloe seemed on the board early. They just didn't feel like they were switched on early, but definitely now they've taken control over the game early on here.
The Lager wind assisted can just punt this one down, gain a couple metres. Is not greedy at all with it.
Reaches the hill, which is absolutely packed out now.
Just need to send a message up to them as well. It's not baseball. You don't get to take that one home with you on the day. It's going to come back down the cliff. Soaks ball. Double fake up at two. Good line out call. And a solid release into the back line.
Oh, it's come out.
Tuiavaki spilling it. Bracey releases. Messy old ruck, need a halfback in there. Noble steps in to do the job. Sorry, not Noble, Masson.
Oh. Number three has not taken a step back in Lynch after a couple blood noses. He's still gone at it very hard.
Cottesloe just trying to find a way forward here. Defense is superb, but the short side opportunity. Stripped through the tackle. Ball goes back Lalaga's way, firing out to Ingram. What's he going to do? He looks up, puts it onto the boot, tries to turn Meredith inside out. Caught just outside the 22, so he's going to have to look up. Charged out. Ingram having a little run. Soaks just need to pick this one up and head over the line.
He's already celebrating. He's happy.
And Caleb Jacobson is going to score the associates' first try of the afternoon. It was all Ingram, though.
You did see Ingram's eyes light up there.
Maybe he thought he was going to get the little check pass ball. I've kicked it. I've charged
reward,
it down.
Yes, yep.
Could I maybe score that try? No, that's all me.
Jacobson says.
Jacobson said, I've been a little bit dry the last couple of weeks. I would not mind a piece of pie for myself. Nevertheless, they get some points on the board and associates are back in this game.
So as I said, Cottesloe came out firing early and it probably didn't look like associates were quite switched on, and now they've flicked the switch and they're out here, and that was great from Ingram and Jacobson coming over the top there. Great outcome for him overall.
It's a good little bit of heads up rugby overall. I like that time. Yeah. Ingram, last time he kind of just looked across the field, yes. Then decided to kick the defenses there. This time looked up and his eyes lit up. He went, I can turn them inside out.
Absolutely.
I can have a little crack here, build some pressure.
For the conversion. And that's all good.
That's all good. So 7 points to 10 is the score in your Fortescue Premier Grade Clash of the Week down here at Harvey Field. And I believe as well, we need to make another correction here this afternoon. That is Vanivere on the left wing. Jersey numbers are wrong on the score sheet. So they got the same headgear on and the wrong jerseys on. So Christian Vanivere on the left wing. Jacobson on the right. So we can jot that one down. Vanivere's made the selfish mistake of going over the line. As we get back underway, high ball on the 22. And all there for Tuivaki to bring it down to ground and take the first tackle of this set. Left side, Dawson. Phillips just finding a small run from Sowney, but it was more of a set-up play for Lalaga to now kick. Nickel. Meredith. Brought to ground just past halfway, centre field. Lost ball now. It's still stuck in the middle of the ruck. Counter ruck comes. Cott was just not doing enough to get that ball out. Referee gave him a collapse ruck to just win that one back, and they decided not to even play. Silly little pass over the top, and it's come off the shin. Probably going to be deemed a knock on. No, gets let off. Tyler Miller from the sideline says that's all shin. And now penalty comes back the other way, straight off feet. Jeez, Associates had a good opportunity there, but that silly pass over the top, Lalaga, just kind of disrupted the play a little bit. And Cottesloe now a chance to get inside the 22. Theo Strang on the boot.
Five.
Seen some quite conservative kicks for touch here this afternoon.
Absolutely. No one wants to make a mistake on those.
Yeah, I know, but there's plenty of meters out there to be gained.
Yeah, I know you're an attacking man. You want to see them go as much as they can, get the full potential out of their kicks.
If you can't take the points, you must get as much territory as possible.
You don't want to play in safe, do you, Nick?
Nah, you got to play to win. Off the top, Nickel, Strang, Marcel. Meredith was a good ball, but well read by the defense. Needed out to the left once again. Chance, if they can get one more pass free. No, takes on the defense. Now pop ball goes out to the left wing. Brought to ground. Marcel Brucky again. The USA Eagle over the top of the ball. Soaks almost penalty. Do get rewarded for it. Was there just long enough. Jesse Elliott, strong body position over the top of the ball. Tobias Hoskins not happy about it.
Absolutely not. He let out a big explicit there and was unhappy that they weren't able to. They looked as though they were going to score there. And when it goes the other way, you cannot be happy as that ball just comes over the back of us there.
And I can see the case Tobias is making there. Yeah, Jesse Elliott got on the ball and he was on for a second there, but the arriving Cottesloe players did blow him off the ball, and that's where I thought he was blown off as well. The penalty was there to be given, but I can see in another world where you could say, nope, he wasn't there for long enough. To look at that one back on review, see what we think of it later as Associates win the ball, fire it across the face, finding Vanivere. Ingram was on the outside, decides to ignore him once again, not making friends those two this afternoon. And a loss forward in the middle of the ruck. Yeah, no, you're not on there, son. Masson, bring that one back, thank you very much.
I like it though, opportunistic.
Well, he doesn't get many. He's a workhorse in the middle of the pack.
He sees him, he's going to take it.
Yeah.
You could just see he's not overly pleased that he's...
It's a lot of energy spent.
On a play that was never going to happen.
Scrum down at the 40. Cott with ball, all set out to the left. Blindside's been left open. Vanivere for Soaks is set up there, though, just in case. Very shallow set to the scrum, though, so he can come open side if he needs. And does so, folds backhanded. Almost obstruction there is obstruction. Bit of lazy ball running. It was a good set-piece move that they set up, but they just ran it at half pace. Kamara getting caught obstruction there. Got a little shove as well, not happy about it. Lalaga to kick this one out. Tap and go, firing it out left. A little bit of an overlap, can they get free? Late pass, Ingram then gets it, Vanivere. Can he put on a little bit of speed? Works here, fires it inside, but it's going to get turned over. Great tackle, Soaks. Just outside their 22, Cottesloe with ball in hand. Hoskins. Turnover coming once again. Just a knock on this time. But Jesse Elliott being an absolute menace at the breakdown, beating everyone from Cottesloe continuously to the ruck. It's going to be a scrum down centre field. 22. Soaks with another big opportunity to attack the line. Currently 10 points to 7 in the first half. And we're going to have time off for a small injury out here on the left. A little bit of a head knock. The finger's gone out in front of the nose. As you see there.
A few casualties out there. Obviously, we've seen Lynch go down with a few nose injuries.
I don't think these boys are taking this afternoon lightly.
Absolutely not.
There's quite a big rivalry between these two clubs. If you're new to rugby in Perth, it's the Battle of Broome Street. Both of these clubs on Broome Street through Cottesloe and Swanbourne.
It's got the nod from the medic and the ref, so the 13 and Ingram. One of two Ingrams out there will take back to the field.
No, not Ingram. That one should be Sifa.
Sifa, sorry.
I don't believe that is. I think it's someone else altogether.
Doing no favours either team on the team sheets.
There was inclusions left, right and centre this week. Ingram in 12. Question mark in 13. Love to see it. Believe we've got the wingers right. Rugby WA, help us please. Rightio. Attacking scrum.
Fine.
Flat attacking setup here for Associates. They look like they're defending. Don't think they realise it's their own ball, but they're running forward. Flat ball now. Phillips backdoor Ingram. What can he create? He's going to go straight through himself. Ingram's going to attack the line. Knocked backwards and then donned over the line. And Associates are going to score. We're going to have a chat about it. But boy, oh boy, wowee, from up here, that looked like a certain try.
And there's a bit going on too between...
give them a little bit of taste after as well, yeah.
They were happy with it. I thought they might have just spent it there, the Soaks, but in the end, it paid off. And who was it in the end?
Well, it was goodbye Ingram initially. Then he went to ground, fired it late, was knocked backwards Cottesloe, then picked up Callum Jacobson to dot it over himself.
Once again, Jacobson, yeah.
The referee's come away with the right decision here because that looked pretty A-OK live.
Sounds like it's been given the tick.
He's just going to explain it to Tobias. Yes, mate, it's going to be a try.
And it is.
Try scored there to Callum Jacobson, Associates. I mean, we can put that one again to Ingram. He's having a good game at 15.
Very good start for Ingram.
He's been involved in both tries very heavily as well.
Yes.
Started at 10 in round one, and then had a little chat after the game with him and Lalaga. Moved Lalaga in from 12 to 10, put Ingram at the back, and he just looks at home at 15 to me. Spent a couple years abroad, now he's come back to Perth, and does he look like he's matured and come good. Certainly was better than me when I played with him.
Oh, boy. I do not doubt that.
That's why I'm up in the box where I can't get concussed. Lalaga from the corner. Just across the face. Got a little bit of the wind. It's going to go across like that. And it's 12 points to 10. Associates take the lead.
Bit of a rev up from the bench here for Cottesloe. Haven't shown a whole heap. They're on the verge a few minutes ago before, once again, the Soaks just took control of the ball. Good few phases. And Ingram pops his head up again. And fantastic plays from him.
Heavy. Just manages to hold on to it, but he was in such a negative body position, but he wasn't held in the tackle. Yes, he was, says the referee. Penalty Cottesloe. And there's a bit of shove after it. They'll have a little chat about it. We'll see what the handbags happen. There's going to be a bit actually involved in this one.
It's always going to happen in the Battle of Broome Street, we know this.
Great call from the Cottesloe bench. Leave it. Getting really involved there, helping their team to keep on the field. Going to come back, still just for a penalty. There was a bit of push and shove. There wasn't too much in it. Now, Seb, if I can bring you back to the team lists once again.
Yes, what's happened now, mate? What are you not happy with?
So Vanavira is left wing.
Okay.
Tavita Sifa is the try scorer right wing. Callum Jacobson is in 13. who we believe is in 12.
Yep. So he's in the 13.
Yeah, Tevita Sifa into 14. Whatever this right wing is wearing. I think he's wearing 23 for some reason. And outside centre is going to be Callum Jacobson. So we got there in the end.
We've got there in the end.
Try scorers of Vanavira and Tevita Sifa. And we're going to come back for a penalty to Cottesloe. Still just having a little chat about things here, though.
I think that needed to be had after what happened after the play there. Just a bit of jumper punches.
It's a decent chat, though. We'll see if I can get a view of the referees.
Both captains and five.
And five. We'll try to get a listen in here. Referees, Mike, just cutting out a little bit, though. Two yellow cards coming here. So referees might cutting out for us up here. I believe it might be for you guys at home too. What I could make out of that and looking at the body language there. So penalty was originally for five not releasing. Then the push and shove came first by five blue. And then third man in, Hemi himself getting up and shoving back. So we're going to go penalty reversal for the initial shove. Both players in the bin for 10 minutes, yellow card. And a clear no more of that in the Battle of Broome Street. Yeah, thank you very much, boys.
It was a long chat, so you knew that had to have come from it. Yeah. So
I mean, it is the Battle of Broome Street at the end of the day.
You're going to get that.
You're going to get something. But we just want to keep it within the broadcast rights, I think, this afternoon.
That's fair call.
Off the back. No one wanted it. Still no one wants it. It's being flicked around everywhere. Now we're going to fire back door for Cottesloe to pick it at the back. Meredith, who can find his winger, Kamara. Lost forward into touch.
Just couldn't find the handle on that one. And he was probably going too quick for his own good there. Spend it before he had it.
Must be nice being able to go that fast, hey? One day. Scrum down far side, Soaks ball. And after that long break, still the forwards want to take their time setting this one up. Just had a break, fellas. Very hesitant to come up to the mark here. Cottesloe 10, Associates 12. In the grand final replay. The Battle of Broome Street. Down here at Harvey Field this afternoon.
Crouch! Bind.
Slow scrum call. Tempo was all wrong there.
Blue, you need to listen to my calls. And when I call crouch, you need to crouch.
Ready to set and go again now.
Crouch! Bind! Set!
Good scrum win by Soaks. Straight onto the boot. He's picked the gap. He's going to find a bit of grass. Kamara first look at it.
Throws an arm out. He's still going here.
Short side. Nickel. Not the greatest pass there. Strang deals with it though. Meredith gets to ground. Popped up. Halfway. Jeez, there's a lot of ball runners moving, but not much of an organised setup here from Cottesloe.
No,
seems they can just start to run in pairs here. Trying to G1 up there. Very good run. Freddy Toa, we believe it is. Penalty, no roll. to go in the first half. You hear from the referee there. Cottesloe two down on the scoreboard. That's a difficult kick into the wind, so they're probably going to go the corner. Yeah, just a little jab from Nickel.
To that limestone wall.
Just a bit short.
A bit short.
It's a good looking bit of limestone, though. Don't mind it at all. Maybe get him to do my backyard.
We've got plenty of sponsors down here on Harvey Field. You think maybe the rest of the wall will be done soon?
One off the top, Associates against the head. Sponsorships don't help lineouts, apparently. Good clearance kick there by Lalaga to get that even further out. So just reapplying the pressure. Back on Cottesloe, driving them back 15, 20 metres. And they'll have to have another crack from deeper out. Clock ticking down in the first half. Very even affair. But if we know both these teams, Associates don't like chasing, and Cottesloe sure do like coming in late in the game, so maybe Associates would love one more before the half, but it might not be the case if Masson can get through. No, dishes that one off. Was a backwards pass, just didn't go to the hand, so it's going to be Soaks ball, no advantage here. Across the back, just a quick little run up, Sowney. Penalty. Straight off feet. Once again, Soaks. Been done a couple times this half for it. Big opportunity now. Easy 3 points to go back in front for Cottesloe if they take it. And you would think you must have to.
Yeah.
Would love to be in front of the half.
The point, and so this is to be ahead. 1 point heading into the second half. It's been an entertaining one so far, Nick.
Yeah, the Battle of Broome Street. It's hard when that one lets you down. Cottesloe went 3 for 3 in their outings last year. 2 in the regular season they won. And then obviously the grand final.
Yes, yep.
But they were a dominating outfit last year, that's for sure. Associates were close on all occasions. Closest in the grand final, only losing after the siren in extra time. But with the kick to come here, Meredith.
Shouldn't find this too hard.
On the 22, should do that in your sleep, dead in front. Does so nicely. 13 points to 12. Cottesloe take the lead back. And there's only a minute or two left in this first half. And the ball boys have been confused. They've got two balls out there. Now one of them's going to take one back.
Nope. Yep.
No, and oh they've left no, one. No, they've left one out
oh
there.
The boys just
and he knows
the
it.
Hams and the palms
good work, Ian Sunderland. He's figured it out.
Yep. And the ball has just been booted.
That's off the stairs. Soaks get us back underway now. Good shaping kick. Can lay a nice hit on the captain, Tobias Hoskins, when he brings that one down. Just concedes. Pocket. Strang. Phillips grabs. Ingram. Lalaga. Oh, thought he was going to do his little chip, but no, went a little bit too long for it. Kick back as well. Up to Robbie Ingram, inside his own 22. Plays it smart, bananas it.
That's
could be us.
Bad on you, Nick. Oh, no.
Wanted a bit of that, wind got it.
Yeah.
I wasn't going to be diving out of the box to get it, though.
I don't think so, no.
Would have been down the hill swiftly there.
Definitely would go against our OHS rules.
Hoskins wins it at 4. Strang. Gave it off to, I believe, Jackson.
No, oh, the big man.
Now Fadia Toa. Strang, not sure who he's going to there. Braki picks up. Penalty. Caught. No clear release. Just a silly penalty there. Straight against Tom Norman. Just a little bit lazy there. Was tackle assist, didn't get round the gate. Shot called again. And a chance to extend the lead before half time, and you think this would be pretty close to it.
Yep.
And I hope we get plenty more of the same in the second half here.
It's been a great start, Nick.
Good start to the Battle of Broome Street. Good start to the Fortescue Premier Grade Clash of the Week. And as I said before, this will hurt Soaks. They hate chasing. Not a chasing
not
side.
Not a chasing side, no.
They're a tail up side. Especially away from home. Danger, danger, danger with all those cop boys on the hill. Meredith really waiting to be set for this one. Now set to engage. Looks left.
No good on that one.
No good there. And we'll enter half time in your Fortescue Premier Grade Clash of the Week, the Battle of Broome Street. It's Cottesloe by one. We'll be right back with your second half. Go into touch. It's just going to be a dropout.
No more.
Takes three to bring him down. Danger once those legs get pumping. Oh, almost between the legs there, Sifa. Lost forward in the contest there. Just a little bit of a messy ruck. Going to see the first scrum of the second half. Beautiful view right in front of us. Been quite neutral in the scrum so far. I believe just the one scrum penalty in the first half. Three goal down. So we'll see how this one goes faring into the second half of this fantastic clash of rugby here this afternoon. Conditions still immaculate. Wind has stayed away completely. Engaged on both sides here. 18 and 1, both in together. Reset.
Good scrums in the first half.
Yeah, don't want it to. I think they're just trying to feel each other out.
Yeah.
Try to get a cheeky penalty each way, both of them there. Dawson taking on Fatty Atoa. Much better setup this time. Good hit. The shove comes from both sides. Cot win the initial battle. They get the march on. Ball available. Comes out. They wanted to keep going, but it just popped out of Tobias Hoskins' legs. Kamara, center field. Gets brought down. Now turnover's going to come. Sifa's all over the ball. Penalty comes. Davida Sifa straight over the ball. Tap and go. Soak straight up the center of the field. Needs support arriving. Don't want the penalty straight back the other way. Good growl off the ball. Messy old ruck. No, he was all rights to it. And straight back the other way. Penalty for the exact same thing. And Strang trying to rip the ball off Phillips.
Get back. Blue, don't chase it.
Oh, Nicker wanted to say something there, but you heard him and just, just held himself. Really well done there, Scott Nicol, to keep himself under wraps. It's funny when he blows up the little man. Strang tries to go up the hill. Soaks try to punch it back in. I think he's done so, but it's lost forward. Oh, hold on. Why is that not play on? Oh, it should be play on.
Yeah, lost low bench here. Nick were just saying, go, go, go. They thought he was out. They thought that was play on.
Yeah, I agree with the decision. Lost forward, but then it's lost forward advantage there to Cottesloe. Oh, a little bit of a brain fade out there, but that's okay. Maybe it was touched by someone over there.
Cottesloe aren't overly disappointed by it. It's a small chat that you have.
Yeah.
It's not like they're devastated.
More a coffee room break than anything else. And a sub coming on here for Associates. Number 16, we'll try to find out who it is for you. Could be Mussie Baker. Believe it would be as well.
Crouch! Bind! Set!
Another solid scrum. Cottesloe now once again with the push. It's down on the far side. Penalty advantage. It's three down straight again. Jaden Lynch struggling if he's still out on the field. He's copped a little bit of a little bit of tussles there from Moai. So penalty advantage still here. Fadiatoa up to the line sharply. Oh, this game's about to get out of control. There's a bit of a scuffle in back play. Handbags there. Sunderland hasn't seen it so far, but gee, this game is about to bust open if you sense anything here. Smart thing to do would be to have a bit of time off here.
It's just a bit of a...
Yeah, calls coming in from Tyler.
Yep. Hasn't gone past Tyler. She's seen it.
No, I think she's calling a separate penalty, actually. I thought she was saying, let's stop the foul play. Yeah. Plenty of time has been taken here.
And
points.
He's going for the points.
Good boys. I mean... It's just what you got to be doing at this level if you want to win games and be the top team in the competition.
This win's just picked up too, so it'll be ideally just about straight in front, slight angle.
Yeah, he's just outside the left upright by the looks of it from our angle. The wind's should be way less than he's used to practicing with as well,
yeah,
so
absolutely.
He should be okay. Meredith is lining it up though. Would not be surprised if the first hit after this
is
penalty attempt,
oh,
it's going to get big. It's the Battle of Broome Street after all. That's why the fans are here to see it. It's why you're tuning in at home. Benjamin Meredith to add the extra three. Looks good inside though.
22
dropout. Score remains 13-12 in favour of Cottesloe. Slow to get the ball back. It's in the sea of cars up on the other hill there. Slowly finding its way in the in goal. And the ball gets taken off with it. And now, through the hands, up to the 22. Let's get ourselves underway. Lalaga looks like he's shaping long. Charge down. Lalaga recovers, gives it off. Ooh, big forward. Shaped up to kick. Wise not to. Ingram.
He's been good so far, Ingram. Oh, he's done well again there.
Yeah, he saw there wasn't much happening on the outside, so just bought himself a bit of time. And now Lalaga's getting released on the far right-hand side. Can give it out once again. Does so nicely. Jacobson to the line. Gave his hands off once again. Elliott to ground. 45 out. That was a good gain for them. Phillips. Fakes, darts himself, tries to get the ball free. Almost turnovers both ways here. Who wants the ball? Associates have Deven back on it.
Offside.
Accidental offside. Penalty to Cop.
Just needed to get more on it there, Cottesloe.
And they come away with the ball and a penalty.
Yep.
That's all right. Inside the 22. Another sub coming for Associates, looking to get these fresh legs on. It'll be Jaden Lynch off, who's fought well after his nosebleeds.
He's a real fighter. Deserves a bit of a spell. You can just see the blood there on his jumper.
Time's on.
And it'll be Siosi Faamoan to come on for him, who has been a starting prop for them this year already. He is quite a quality replacement to bring on. Good maul set up by Cottesloe again, a little bit wide, so it's going to be hard to find the power base. Hoskins has popped up in the middle, just absolutely stuck in the middle there, so they have to peel left and they make another maul. But now Associates getting back on them. They need to just hold this one up now, not get too greedy on the push. And they might end up with the ball here shortly if this one goes to ground. Ball available though. Kotozlov done well to keep this one. Counter ruck starts coming.
No. He broke off. Gents, he's broken off the maul already, and then he's been tackled. It's gone to ground. It's not coming out. It did.
Yeah, correct call there from the referee. Came out of the maul. So it just is a tackle. That was a collapsed ruck if I've ever seen one as well. No chance that was coming out.
Reedy's coming on here for Cottesloe as well.
A big Kaiser Reedy.
Kaiser Reedy, yep.
Does normally start for them as well. I think he's had a couple of calf knee injuries as well. So just on managed minutes, I believe.
Yeah, you can just see that heavy strapping on the left calf there. So hopefully doesn't hold him down in this second half.
Oh, I think he's under the instructions of, we'll give you limited minutes, but you're going
to
absolutely let fire for us.
Yep.
So two replacement props on. And they're not scrumming against each other. They've put each other on the opposite sides to try wheel this one round.
Benny Harkin coming off that Crouch. Glorious blonde mullet. Lots going on there.
Heaps of party, not much business. Just have a reset. Fresh props, that's all right. Get your distance set, boys. Want to make sure this is all set, ready to rock. Set now. Cottesloe are getting popped up at the front here. Oh, the advantage goes against him. That could have gone either way. Guard diving towards the corner. Cottesloe with ball in hand. Pods out to the right. Decide to pick and go. Still short of the line. Half a metre to go. Need to find the ball. Get it free. Pods there. Still short. Associates doing well to hold them up. That's a tackle, got to let go now. Shifting back left, but plenty of Soaks numbers. They're committing a lot to these tackles, that they're going to run themselves too ragged. They're going to string their numbers too thin.
Release!
Backs have got to be out of fire soon.
Advantage again.
Penalty advantage offside.
Goal 16. There. On.
Now the backs will go with the fresh advantage. Big back door to Meredith. Outside, Bracky one-on-one with Ingram. Oh. Gets inside the first. Couldn't beat Vanavere, though. Sifa comes in to help. Will come back for the penalty.
You can see Ingram there, half the size of Bracky, and you can tell he knew.
He knew all. He knew. And he knows exactly who he is. He goes, I'm taking on the USA Eagle Western Force winger, Marcel Bracky, and I'm Thomas Ingram, 5 foot
yes.
10. Having a good game, but this will test me, but he did well.
He did very well under the circumstances.
So just having a chat about the number of penalties in the red zone there. Time is off. Still 13 points to 12.
Okay, let's go, yellow.
Scrum's the call. They reckon they can get another scrum penalty out of it. I think the last one could have gone either way there as well. So a see what happens in this scrum. The replacement props on both sides, as I've said, they're both very experienced campaigners up front. So I wouldn't say either team's at fault. Could have been in front a little bit on the push. Big scrum.
Fine.
Free kick, closing the gap. Not good enough discipline by Cottesloe. And penalty,
oh,
back
no.
Chat. Fadia Toa.
You could just tell he let something out there right as he turned away and referee wasn't happy with it.
I mean, it's a pretty simple penalty, the closing the gap. Well, it's just a free kick.
Yep.
Now it's a penalty.
Yeah.
Lucky to not get an extra 10 on it as well. And Soaks release the pressure. Get 39 out from their own line. And they'll have the ball in hand off the line out. Full line. Back set to crash. Almost a turnover. Jacobson comes away with it in the end. Sorry, Dawson. Inside ball to Ingram. Well floated. Phillips diving. Lager gets it in behind. One bounce inside the 22. Meredith might look for touch here. Does so. The wind's going to stop it, though. Lager testing ball on the run. Gets it. Fires it on the run. Sowney gives it out. Ingram. Dummies to his brother. Now Phillips. Now wider again still. Lots of ball runners. Lots of movement there. Noble to ground. Slow play. Ingram steps into 10. Lalaga, short pop ball. That one was lucky to not be called forward. And now it goes lost forward in the tackle on the second attempt. And now forward again. Scrum down, Cottesloe ball.
Yeah, previously Cottesloe thought they'd seen a forward ball, but when they saw that one, that was quite a clear one.
Jesus.
Oh, they kept it a little bit more quieter.
Yeah, that was very, very, very quiet.
Came off. Knocked on by Blue here.
I'm not sure why all the drinks are coming out onto the field. I know Phillips is down, but now we've got time off. There we go. So roughly 15-odd minutes into the second half of the Fortescue Premier Grade Clash of the Week, the Battle of Broome Street. Still Cottesloe by one. Have you seen the first 15 minutes play out here?
Yeah, well, it's been topsy-turvy, hasn't it? Obviously, we saw a bit going on with those yellow cards in that first half, but we haven't seen quite that sort of intensity in this second half. I expected to come out. Has been some words of the ref that has cost some Cottesloe players, but look, it's a big game to play out here. It's always is the Battle of Broome Street and a grand final rematch, and they're just huddling together now just to have a chat about what they can do in the latter stages of this one.
And Lockie Phillips, he does not look happy with himself here. He had a little hobble. He's gone back to ground. Not sure who they've got really in halfback reserves. It might have to be Rob Ingram to step in. Doesn't favour it. He's going to get it strapped up, which signals that he's probably going to stay out on the field. But when you look at their bench, no real recognised halfback out there, so they probably need him to stick in for as long as he can. And you definitely want Ingram running onto the ball from 15, not passing it at 9.
He's been fantastic at 15, Ingram. So, as you said, that switch up for him has definitely benefited the Soaks here.
Certainly had a big piece in both those first two tries. Created both opportunities.
Yep.
Could have executed both as well.
Absolutely.
Unlucky to not
probably
be having a double.
A dirty, yep.
As we wait for Phillips now, just getting the strapping on his leg. Forwards look ready to go. That's a shock. They want to see some more rugby.
And so Phillips back up on his feet. No real hobble there, so it looks like he will tough this one out.
It's not the heaviest strap you've ever seen as well, so hopefully it does the job for him for a second. Physio is on the radio about it.
Happy with its job.
Guys, I've done that one nicely. Clip that. Clip that one, send that to Curtin. See if you can land him a scholarship for his masters on that strapping alone. Scrum down, 25 out from the line. Cotter got it centre field. They got three set on the short side of the left here. penalty. Cott straight through, pulling out.
And there's a bit going on. They're going on with it. Cottesloe very happy with their work there. Associates a little bit heads down.
Yeah, they're starting to lose it a little bit at scrum time here.
Cottesloe probably looking a little bit bigger out there now in this second half compared to the first half.
Yeah, all of a sudden they seem about a foot taller.
Yeah.
Don't know how, don't know why. But they're standing a little taller than those associates. As I said, they don't like chasing.
They don't.
Cottesloe come in hot in the second half.
You do say chase, but it's not a large chase. You could.
It's very, a mindset. Close, it's a mindset. They don't like. They like to be in front.
Yep.
Everything but in front seems to trouble them sometimes in a second half in a hot contest like this. Cott send this one long, but it goes up over the back of everyone. Numbers. Numbers is the call here in Sunderland. Soaks had too many in the line. Big lucky break there because they were up and away. Free kick. Option, I'd probably be going the scrum. You could get another penalty out of it. Yep. Jeez, so Soaks are going to have to just forget the push here now.
Yeah.
For the rest of the half, dig in your feet, set low, set long. Just really try to hold these Cock guys off, especially on their on Cock feet. It's hard to win a scrum penalty against the head.
They've got to find something here.
Because the backs, they've got the talent. And in fact, their backs have looked better than Cots today, which isn't the way it looks on paper always. And I want to see a little bit more out of breaking.
Yeah.
He's moved from outside centre to the wing now, his natural position, and I want to see him light something up.
I'm telling you, Nick, he was just about to blow. I reckon he's going to do something very special soon.
I don't think we've seen it. This is a better scrum by Soaks. Yeah, that's much better. They've come round and through, and they've tapped and go, but the referee hasn't seen it, and he's going to blow that back, I betcha. Oh, I betcha. You're joking. No, it was not on the mark at all. I was just playing with him. That's a better scrum by Soaks. See, they just sat there.
So they did dig deep there, as we asked, but now they've got to put it into motion.
And now you've got to keep ball in hand. Avoid the scrum is the name of the game here now. Another replacement about to come for Associates. It's going to be their third front row replacement.
Number.
And it's number 18,
number
Scott Tolmie.
Gold one.
The point scorer for the second grade side here.
It is Scotty Tolmie.
As you guys watching at home might not know, but he plays up front. He's a big man, the number 18, but
he's got wheels though.
He's got wheels, and he's got one of the best kicks in the comp.
Absolutely.
He's goal kicking.
He's a dead eye.
He's a dead eye. Kicks off a cone, not a regular cone. Kicks off a plastic marker cone.
Yep.
But he's been doing it for about 15 years off that cone.
It's niche, and I love it.
And works every single time. Center field crash ball.
Look at
love that. This is what you want to see now. A bit of forward ball running. Bit of aggression in the line.
Oh, Phillips there.
Oh, be careful of his ankle. We had to go there, but that's a danger run when you're already half injured. Need a half back in. Pops it nicely. Gets it across the face now. Sowney trying to get through the first, but held on by the ankles.
You say be careful of Phillips' ankle there. We know how good that strapping was put on.
It seems to have held up through the first bit of contact. I'm pretty happy with it. Dragged into touch. And Cottesloe have gone quickly across the back, not touched by anyone. Meredith fires it. Oh, what a hit. Vadivere has absolutely lined up the USA Eagle and sent him packing to the ground. That is what you want to see. I don't care that you play international rugby, young man. Well, experienced man.
Yeah.
This is the Battle of Broome Street, and this is my forte. But then he gives away a silly penalty like that.
And look, he's just handed it straight back, so...
He was a bit up and about.
Yeah, I would have been too.
I want to give him a free pass, but, you know, just take the small win.
Yeah. Put that in the bank.
Put it in the bank. I'll be talking about it, that one, at the
absolutely,
bar later.
Absolutely.
Did you know I'm better than an international? Jeez, now Robbie Ingram's going, I wish I hit him that good. If Robert Ingram hit him that good, he'd be up and about all afternoon.
I know.
Would have scored a hat trick.
You would have seen the head wobble go around. I don't know if he would be able to keep up on his feet because the head would have been that big.
Cottesloe, 40 out from the line. Call comes from Tobias Hoskins, and he jumps at three. Holds it for a second.
Ball. Hoskins going for a ride here.
Get out, five, get out.
Yeah, he's out, don't worry, Ian. Down the short side, needs to be wrapped up.
Leave it now, leave it.
opportunity for Cottesloe to build a big attack here. Reedy.
Yes, Reedy.
Straight into the line.
No, Carl's not holding his him back.
No, Nickel lets it free. Bit of dancing, bit of jigging. I'm not sure who, but he looks good doing it.
10 offside.
Penalty advantage coming.
He's Brakey.
Brakey has another crack and gets wrapped up again.
Number 10, offside.
Jeez, he wants to have a crack now. Look at him. You see the smile on his face. He knows he's been done twice in a row.
Yep.
That time it was Lalaga and Sifa.
He went head first too. He was going hard there. He's gone for points, so.
Yeah, this is a good option here. Got to make this one go over. Look at Bracey. He's got a big smile on his face. He knows he's been done twice in a row. He wants to get involved in the game. But the Battle of Broome Street, the atmosphere proving to be challenging for him. I don't think he's going to give up there, though. I think now he's going to start. I don't think he's going to give up till he breaks the advantage line at least once here.
He wants something, Brakey.
So Meredith for the three. To make it 16-12.
Important points here.
Huge points here. Good strike over the black dot, 16-12. And the Battle of Broome Street is entering the final quarter. And the ball kids have got two balls out there again. They figured it out.
Yeah, the communications between them hasn't been strong today, but they've got it right this time.
I think they're just keen. They know the atmosphere's out there this afternoon. They want to be involved.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Out in the field as long as they can.
Minutes. High kickoff. Awkwardly brought to ground. It was a weird Star Frog jump, but well held by Fargoni nonetheless. Caught in the centre of the field. Messy ruck. Strang.
Oh, Ingram.
Dots it down.
Doesn't go past him.
Fires at Lalaga. Good line here by Cottesloe to come up and meet them. Lalaga gets the hands free. Sifa.
Breaky.
Yeah, now he gives a little bit of taste back. He saw the green headgear, but it was the wrong man.
Yeah.
It's not the right one with the green headgear. Even I'm not in trouble. Phillips grubbers through. Phillips is going to win the foot race. Does he get the lucky bounce? He's on top of the ball. Plays it backwards now. Support's there, but the counter ruck from Cottesloe is big. They need to get the ball free now. No, lost forward in the contact. And Lockie Phillips has given it everything this afternoon.
He has, obviously being hampered with that ankle injury as well. The physio's come out, strapped it up, given it the tick, all good to go, and he looks about 100%.
I don't know if I can give a physio three votes for the entire game, but at least one.
At least one.
He's up the leaderboard somewhere.
He just needed that lucky bounce to go to favour his on his side. It just didn't quite.
Just stayed on the ground, moving to the right. If it popped up for him, he's quick. He could have been away there.
Even with that fantastic strapping of the ankle.
Oh, if the ankle wasn't strapped, I think he would have got that off one bounce,
absolutely,
not two.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Defensive scrum, Cottesloe, who have been in control of the contest.
Fine.
Can they hold on to this one and exit properly? Both front rows up on this side. It's going to be a penalty the way of Cottesloe once again. Not straight push.
Oh,
they had the loose head popped on this side, but they didn't push equally.
No, far side.
Yeah, far side up. Near side stayed straight. So they got the pop, but not the straight push. And the scrums are going to be a big point of contention on review, but Ian Sunderland's handled them very well this afternoon. He's seeing a good pitcher at the moment. That's why he's being rewarded with games like this. Cottesloe don't add too much extra distance.
You can just see the crowd there. They've come out for this battle of Broome Street.
Yeah, they're all starting to get involved now. See on the wall there, all the Soaks boys, legs crossed, matching each other. Good to see.
Yep.
Over the back, once again, stolen. It's Tolmie. Gets to ground inside the 22, and Soaks have a real opportunity to attack. Crashing the ball straight up. Is that Simone? Believe it is. Takes them all on. Still fighting through the line. Needs to present the ball now. Penalty advantage coming.
Phillips
wants a bit of the pie. He's held up short. Needs to play that one back. Who's going to pick and drive here for Soaks? No, we'll have the penalty regardless.
Wow.
And we're going to have a chat about it too. Could have been cynical. Picturesque afternoon when you look at that shot. We'll have a listen to the referee. 6 straight off, professional foul, playing the ball on the ruck, 1 meter out from the line.
Oh, wow.
So 10 minutes in the bin with 15 left on the clock. Down by 4, this game's about to crack wide open if Soaks can convert here. Now, every single coach in senior rugby in Perth says, have a scrum or take the line out. Nick Neary says, take the points, plenty of time left.
Nick is happy to take the points.
Down by 1, 10 to go, I'm more than happy to play, but they're going to take a scrum where they've just got 6 penalties in the second half against them.
JP, you keep straight and square.
So they need to make sure they get this scrum right here, associates. It's a big call to take on the scrum. Boy, oh boy, wowee.
Here.
You reckon Ingram's got another one in him?
I think Ingram's looking like he's got a sparkle in his eye.
Yeah, it's Ingram and Vanavere out to the left here. La Liga Sifa, Ingram out to the right. Phillips looks like he's shaping left, but the ball wasn't there to go. Gonna have it again. Ground's gonna be unstable there near the 5. A little bit of turned up grass there.
Ingram's just having a chat there with Phillips.
Benavirro getting involved.
Benavirro just says, hey, what about me?
I'll be there.
Yeah.
I want it here. Not here, here.
So Ingram just says, hey, all right, nick off.
Yeah.
This one's mine.
You just be in the corner. I know you want it here, but I want you there. I want you there. Good hit.
Big scrum here.
Soaks look like they're in control. Need to get it free. Oh. 8 picks. Nickel does well to bring him to ground immediately. Needs to roll out of there. Phillips now. Vanavere gets brought to ground. 5 out from the line.
Ingram's there. Ingram's on the left there.
No, we're just going to go back through the forwards. Sowney towards the line. Nickel's in danger with a calf injury on the floor. Backdoor Lalaga. He likes to have a crack at the line under the sticks himself. Heaps of players down in back play. 2 for Cott, 1 for Soaks. Diving towards the line. Is it Tolmi? He's over the line, held up. Oh, Scott Tolmi nearly scores in 2 grades this afternoon.
Wow, what an effort that would have been, Nick.
Would have been about his 15th point for this afternoon.
Came crashing through and you thought, oh, has he got it here? And there's just casualties everywhere. There's a couple, there's a calf injury for 2, I believe. I think it might just be a cramp.
Yeah, so we've got Nickel with a cramp.
Nickel with a cramp.
And we've got a head clash between Bracky and Vanavere. Both of them aren't looking too... Vanavere's down still. Bracky's up.
Yeah, you don't expect Bracky to stay down for too long. Vanavere, obviously...
He's got a point to prove in this.
Yes, exactly right. And Vanavere's just got a strong head as well, but he's still down. He's having a look at him, having a chat.
Doesn't look too good, though.
He's an important player.
Oh, he's a huge ball runner for the associates.
Nickel is still having some trouble. Is it a cramp?
Nickel's a danger to go off as well. Yeah. There's no halfback replacement really for Cottesloe at the moment, unless they got Rory Edwards on the bench.
Huge.
Which I don't mind if he came into the piece, but it doesn't look like he's warming up at all there.
Yeah. I'll just have to give him the nod. Say, hey.
Yeah, Nickel.
I'd be
telling the coaches I'm fresh, I'm ready.
Yeah.
I can't even see him. I don't think maybe he's on the hill. He's listed. Oh no, there he is. There he's in the jacket. He's got the jacket on, staying warm. Yep, Rory Edwards. So there we go. I didn't catch. So yeah, Rory Edwards on for Scott Nickel. And I believe Joshua Pretorius is on for Vanavere as well.
So
number 14.
Huge out.
Huge out. And now Pretorius, he's not the biggest winner. And now he's got to take on Brachy on the left wing.
Oh boy.
If I was Soaks, I'd probably be swapping the wings over. Get Sifa on the left wing instead of playing inside center, outside center there.
Huge task.
Yeah. Back to the action. Scrum 5 meters out. Soaks have ball in hand. Down by 4. 13 odd left in the game. 8 picks again. Gets it to Phillips. Phillips gives it off. Lalaga.
Got it. Lalaga.
And Soaks are going to go over and score underneath the post.
Got it.
Simple as that. Draw
wow.
And pass. 8-9, then
wow.
10. And Soaks are going to hit the front with a kick to come. A brilliant bit of play off the back of the scrum. Well, it was a very simple bit of play.
Yep.
I think the Cottesloe backline were expecting way more.
Yeah.
And little draw and passes gets Lager over for one of the easiest tries. And because he knows he's kicking it too, he made sure he got round behind the sticks. Let me make sure I've got... I'm going to make sure I kick this one. Sets himself up 10 in front of the sticks. So 16 plays 17, kick to come.
Shouldn't have any issues here. But he's been very good today, the Lager. Yeah. Sorry, what have Cottesloe got in the bank here?
They are a good finishing side. They know how to go deep.
So now this obviously Soaks are ahead, so they'd be happy now.
They're not chasing. It is more of a half-time mantra, but I'll give you that. Yep. I'll give you that. They're in front. And a huge substitution. Marcel Brekke.
Is Brekke coming off here?
Yeah, his head's not okay. He is looking a little bit fuzzy still from the contact. If Vanavira has gone off with it and he had a headgear, I can't imagine how Brekke stayed out there so long. So a replacement once again.
Inside
the 22, Chase was coming heavily. Don't have a name for the replacement, the 23 at the moment, but we'll see what we can do for you. Pocket. Robbie Ingram. Turns the fullback inside out. At the back, Meredith. Big shouts of forward from the Soak supporters. I don't think it was. The replacement winger is out there now, though. Dots the ball down. Edwards, first good bit of pill from him. Hoskins brought down centre field. Strang, back door, Meredith. Meredith, I think he grubbed it. Oh. And it's still through the boots. Tommy.
Ingram!
Gone backwards,
does well to stay in control of himself.
Let it come!
Lost ball now. Looks like they want to have a bit of a run here, Soaks. They don't want to kick this one away. Roughly 8 minutes to go by my watch. Lalaga, who's been fantastic. Good ball on the outside. Pretorius beats the first, gets dragged into touch on the second. It was a really good run there. Good run there by Pretorius, his first touch of the afternoon. I believe the 23, Tommy?
I believe it was Tommy. Tommy is the word.
Tommy is the word. Didn't have a name for him, now we do.
Thank you.
Hoskins up at four, winning off the top. Kamara. Just wrapped up centre field, nowhere to really go here. Soaks might get a turnover if this gets any messier, and they do. Tolmi. Ingram. Penalty coming back.
Yeah, he's down, but he's still... Still
being
head contact.
Oh, and the home crowd aren't.
The away crowd, sorry.
Aren't high tackle. Happy about that.
I think the call came in from the sideline late there.
You were hinged at the waist.
And finds touch nicely on the Soaks 40. Slaps the wall hard.
Yeah.
Numbers blue.
Soaks by three.
Numbers. Seven.
Soaks by three. Probably seven to play.
You can just hear the crowd getting behind him now. It's a big finish coming.
All the goals getting up. Hoskins up at three. Gets it. Don't know what that was from Rory Edwards. Doesn't need the triple cutout from there. Kamara straightens up though. Takes it on himself. Gets just back to the advantage line. Fadiatoa.
Oh, wow.
Good leg drive, but loses it forward. Scrum called. Calls from the sideline as well to just clear this one, get the territory game going. Start winding the clock down and make sure you're in the opposition half. Got a feeling Cotter going to put a bit into this scrum, though. If I'm Soaks, I'm just trying to lock this one down again because... Kasaridi and Fadiatoa are going to have an absolute crack at this one. A reverse penalty here is the one to play for.
The shorts are getting pushed up. They're getting low.
So there's not much shorts anyway.
No. He's going to have to crouch. Bypass that calf issue. Give it to his all.
Good hit. Little bobbled on the far side, but they hold it steady. Ooh, bit of an angle here on this side, but the ball comes free, so we play away. Lalaga goes centre field, gets the turn of the head, needs this one to sit up now, can't go too long. Has to play it. Deep in his own 22, not the best kick, it's not out. Can fire it off. Half of a late hit, but that's okay. Lalaga fires it wide. Simone out on the left wing. He's got Pretorius on the outside. Takes on the bit of contact up inside the 22. And Soaks start to feel a bit of energy here once again. Sounie, backdoor, Lalaga. Lalaga, another cutout pass. Not sure why we're throwing so many now, boys, but it works out nonetheless. Hemi brought down center field. We're coming back for an offside penalty. Believe it was Kamara on the kick chase, started to angle in when he was well offside from the play before.
Give the option of a scrum, offside here, or scrum where he kicked it. Okay.
Scrum down there is the call.
Scrum back here.
So good call from the referee. Didn't call it live because I didn't think it was he was going to have as much of an effect as he did, but Kamara on the kick retreat, he was up at halfway, came straight across to the ball runner, was nowhere near onside. Option there, scrum inside the red zone. Soaks are on again. Another replacement coming on here for Associates. Number 21, Todd Lewis, replacing Lockie Phillips finally, who's had a very good second half, Lockie Phillips. He's been attacking the line nicely.
Especially, you can just see the ankle, the strapping. We might have to take those points away, those votes away from the physio because...
Did another layer or two, maybe you could have got the 80 done. You know, I've got still about 4 minutes left. That's another layer at least.
Yep.
You know, it's compound interest basically. The more layers it actually goes up, you know.
So yeah, he'll be staring up at the ceiling tonight, that physio, wondering what could have been.
Inside the 22, scrum down, Soaks ball. Lalaga gets it and fires a flat ball to Ingram, who gets chopped off at the legs, didn't even have hold of the ball, losing it forward, and we're gonna have a scrum. Good let off, good defense. Well done, Cop.
Now, the Cottesloe bench now just stressing 5 minutes to go. So how much have you got, Nicky?
Yeah, I'm just under four.
Just under four, so I guess we're about to find out. But
I could have missed a time off somewhere. Yeah. Who knows? Lots going up in the box here this afternoon. Can't be so diligent with my watch. Cottesloe scrum inside their own 22. Need to get some points soon. How they go about it, there's many ways to do it. Let's have a reset. Oh, and he's going to go penalty straight down. Interesting. Couldn't quite see what's happening at the front there. We'll have to trust him. But not what Soaks needed. That's an absolute gift, but that's not out. That's not a great kick at all.
Ingram says, thank you, mother, for the rabbits.
Brought down to ground on the 40. Replacement half back in there. Now Sounie inside ball, Simone. Still leg driving forward, Simone. Ball available at the back here. Lewis, Ingram, faking. And it's a tackle, must release.
Calling offside the Cottesloe bench there.
No, there was no obstruction there. Brought to ground nicely. Soaks just slowing this play down. Now Lalaga, he'll accelerate things. Chips over to the top towards the limestone wall we love so well. Brought back by Meredith. It beats the first and the second. It starts to get the legs moving. Now on the outside, Kamara murks his way up to halfway. Plenty of forward runners out to the right here. Tobias Hoskin, he wants a crash ball. Gets it now. They're not offside at all. Thank you very much, Cottesloe. That's okay. Kaiser Reedy. Big bump off on the first bit of contact. Now we are open side again. Fighting towards the line. Cottesloe need to find something magical. Strang touched. Soaks are going to have to get back on top of this one. Pretorius dives on it. And it's going to be lost forward.
He's knocked it on.
Accidental knock on into his own player. Pretorius was diving. I believe it was Jesse Elliott. Just didn't communicate with each other. And they clashed into each other.
How big would the USA Eagle be here?
Yeah, you'd love to see him out there, but he was rocked on the head, so I don't know. And he's still on the ground down there.
I don't think we'll see him again, but wow. No. This is his time to shine.
1 minute to go on my watch. Cottesloe down by four. It's the Battle of Broome Street. It's the grand final replay. It's your Fortescue Premier Grade match of the round. Crouch. One big run will do it here. Who's going to be the man for Cottesloe to try it?
Crouch. Bind. Set.
Straight down. Both sides here. Needs to fix his angle here, three.
Listen for my calls.
Don't want to see another scrum penalty here. We just want to see some good rugby. Want to see someone from the Cottesloe backline absolutely take it to this formidable defensive associates that has been here this afternoon, all afternoon.
Crouch! Bind!
Panshi Kamara in number 11, set at an outside centre, little cutout position. Could crash it in to Sifa.
Oh, wow.
Cottesloe just hang on. Soaks with a big scrum. Strang has to go himself. Didn't have many options this time.
No, stay out.
Rory Edwards picks it out. Inside centre, bumping off one. Trying to find a way through. Wow. Still shrugging off a couple, but now driven back in the contest. Lost his momentum. Lalaga tries to attack the contest. Cottesloe not happy about the clean out attempt, but it had no material effect on much at all.
Soaks really coming out of here, Nick.
Yeah, line speed's terrific at the moment. It was a good tackle, Noble. Deep ball. Meredith trying to find a way through. He's struggling through everything, but he's doing a good job at it.
He's been big late here.
Yeah, he's had a cracking second half, Meredith. Now popped free.
Release.
Being quiet out there, Marcy, this afternoon.
Oh,
but
wow.
Could be the man for them. Fadia Toa works it up to the 22. Doesn't take no for an answer when
Ingram
driving those legs.
Sort of took a hit from him there and said, all right, I'll back off.
Penalty advantage, offside. Kamara dishing out wider. Opportunities now in Cottesloe's favour. Jackson goes to ground. Just touching the 22 still here. Cottesloe need to find an opportunity. We're going to come back for the penalty. And the points won't do it. They're down by four. What's the option going to be? Scrum or line out? It's a big kick for a line out. It has to be a scrum. Taking the points to level it up. So Cottesloe, controversially, are going to draw this one up. Don't know if there's any time left on the watch. By mine, there isn't. This would mean a 19-all draw if it is full-time.
What an end, eh?
I mean, for none of these boys to take away the points.
Oh, wow.
Would be absolutely controversial. I wouldn't be surprised if there's some unsavoury words from Soaks after. Meredith to level the game, potentially the end of the game. Oh, he's missed! He shanked it right. I mean, shanked it to the left from dead in front. Meredith, who's been good with the boot all day, has absolutely shanked one. And Soaks are going to win the Battle of Broome Street, the grand final rematch, 19-16. I can't believe they've actually missed that kick. And
Meredith
maybe
was
now.
So good in this second half. He lifted so much, and you just thought, he's got this, it's in the bag, and he's missed that.
And I hate to bring it back to the first 5 minutes of this game, but Caleb Young would have drilled that one over the sticks, and Cottesloe have lost the Battle
You've
of Broome Street.
Rub some salt into the wounds there, Nick. But
thank
right,
you very much, everyone,
right,
for joining us. We'll grab some interviews in a second, but we'll catch you all next week with the Fortescue Premier Grade Match of the Round.